When I hear people bring up grammar in daily conversations, most of the time it's interchangeable with proper grammar. Ain't a word. Double negations are ungrammatical. Always use who as a subject, but whom as an object. Following these kinds of rules makes your speech sound polite, educated, and prestigious. This proper grammar is telling you how to use your language. Linguists call it prescriptive grammar because it prescribes certain words and structures. If prescription demands that you follow certain grammar rules, it's a linguistic do this. Proscription prohibits you from breaking rules. It's a linguistic don't do that. But now you've come over to the Native Lang channel, and you've started watching the videos here, and these videos talk about grammar differently. You learn that in Catalan, a language native to eastern Spain, they put articles before proper nouns. El fill de la Joana literally means the son of the Joanne. But that's how they say the son of Joanne, or Joanne's son. Maybe you even find out that in earlier English, double negatives were common and expected, like in Nan ne dorste nan thing askian. Yup, that is English, and it literally means no one dared not ask nothing. These are real-life descriptions of language. This is descriptive grammar. Notice the difference. One approach attempts to dictate how speakers ought to speak their language. The other one captures and documents language objectively, as it is being used, not as some people wish it were used. Historical descriptions show us that prescriptive rules go into and out of fashion. Double negatives were once mainstream in English, but now they're marginalized. Cultural differences show us that prescriptive rules don't apply to all languages, so they're not fundamental to human language or grammar. Yes, from this perspective, the prescriptive rules you hear from grammar geeks and style guides sound flighty and incidental, but before we shout, "Nobody tells me what to do," and race to dump prescriptivism in the trash, let's think about the possible upside. Establishing a standard language could boost social cohesion. Monumental works of literature, standardized reference resources like dictionaries, and the education of a highly literate population traditionally involve, and maybe even depend on, some amount of prescriptivism. Prescriptivism and descriptivism both talk about language use, but both of them stop short of offering a model of human language. A model explains human language. It's a theory of language. For example, Chomskyan theories of generative grammar see language as a group of rules that, once activated in the right way, will produce the structure of a specific language. On the other hand, functional theories of grammar see language as a linguistic instrument for communicating in social situations. Prescriptive, descriptive, theoretical. You'll sound smart when you get the chance to work these concepts into at least one upcoming conversation. What's more, now you can see some of the reasons behind dividing the study of language into different fields. I hope you've enjoyed this topic as much as I have. Please subscribe for more on linguistics, languages, and logic in the future, and thank you for learning with me.